Well, what do we have here? Harley, what do we have here?
We have a 2006 Chrysler Town & Country with a 3.3 liter, and we have a 2009 Chrysler Town & Country with a 3.3 liter. Now, these vehicles here are kind of the exact same vehicle, but there's some quite differences between them. I want to go through what I don't like about this, and what I don't like about this, and then I'm going to tell you guys on which one I think would be the better vehicle actually out of the two. There's some things about this one I like, and there's some things I kind of don't like about it, and same with this one. But let's go through each one of these vehicles and see what I like and what I don't like, so that you guys can pick which one you want to derby. So overall, between the two vans, I actually liked building this one better. There's some reasons for that, but let's go to this one first. I like the front bumper more on this one, but I don't really like the rad support because it's plastic. The frame on this one is a lot straighter. I do like that, rather than this big curve up like that. Computer was right here, but it was super easy to pull up and come up to here without even unplugging it. So that's a plus for this one. On this van, I did have to unplug the computer to move it, and it doesn't really have enough length to reach up there. So that is a downside for this one. Some things I like about this one: power steering is in a much better location. This one right here was on the air box, and I just kind of wired it to the alternator. Just little things like that make a difference to me. The motor mounts on this one do look a little bit better. They are aluminum up here, but down there, that motor mount looks better. I know that that motor mount gives you issue on these ones, so I do think that that one there has got a better front motor mount. Overall, for the front, I'm going to say this one is better than this one, but that could all be coming out in the wash, who knows. Some things I didn't like about this van is the different bolt pattern. So none of my doubles will fit this, and I have to have the specialty rims just basically for this van. But saying that, this one here has got the 5 on 4.5, so a lot of doubles will fit, but Camry rims do not fit because they hit the center, brake discs. So you would have to space them out. Something I liked about this one is how easy these side windows came out. These were all just bolted in, and when I unbolted them, they fell down a bit, and they were super easy to get out, same as these ones, super easy to get out. That one back there, the side window was not the easiest to come out, but it did come out without breaking. The back ones were super easy to get out. The panels were actually a lot easier to get off on this. I found that there was a lot more screws compared to that one. But overall, they're about the same to strip. They're pretty easy. There was a lot more airbags in this one. I still think there's some that I haven't even found, but I don't give a crap about that. I haven't got this one out, mostly because I haven't figured out how to get it out. I know you got to take it out from the back. I just haven't found the right size to jam in there. I do think these large stone goes in the floor are going to be weak, because I can stand on them and bend them. But this van here is not stow and go, but you can get this van in stow and go. So the stow and go I don't think is a big option. I think the ones without stow and go might actually be tougher because they're flat and they're straight. In the back end, this thing's got leaf springs. I think that the leaf springs are gonna be super, super tough on this. I actually know that they're super tough. When this one here does not have leaf springs, this one here has trailing arms and coil springs. As you can see down here, it's got a solid axle, just kind of like that, but I do think the rear suspension is going to be tougher on that. Now for the backs, I don't really know. I do want to pull both rear bumpers off these to save them for kind of other cars, because let's face it, I'm having to buy all these bumpers now. So I'm probably going to pull both rear bumpers off and save them, just so that we have an even playground when we come to derby these things. They're pretty much built the exact same, with the wiring moved the exact same. Basically, no welding, just the doors are going to be seatbelted shut, stuff like that. But that's my advantages, is I think this one's easier to strip. I think it's going to have a little bit tougher of a front end. This one here was very easy to strip. I think it's going to have a little bit tougher of a back end, maybe even quite a bit tougher back end. But in the front, this one was much easier. I don't know, it's kind of like a flip your coin. We'll have to see how they do in the Derby. I do think this one here is going to actually be better, even though it's super, super rotted. I do think this van's gonna be better. And that's because I think this one's just gonna have electrical issues. It kind of doesn't want to start. If I jump the starter, I have to actually turn the key. I think that the alternator is going to start giving me issues. I think that a lot of the electrical is going to be unhappy with me. Even though they're the same motor, there are different electrical and computer systems inside them. So, I don't know. I painted this one here with my 171. I painted it with my buddy's shark teeth on the back because I plan to drive backwards, but I'm just kind of mocking him with this, so don't worry about it. And then I painted the shark teeth on the front of his because he's going to hate the paint job. He's going to repaint it. I bet you any money he's going to repaint it. But there, honestly, guys, I want to go have some fun. If I win, I'll probably donate the money to a different class because I don't care. This is just a for fun van. Me and my buddies are going to go there and just try to smash the snot out of each other in different vans. But there's still little things left to do, like the front window bar. He's got to put his front window bar on that one. And just seatbelt the door shut. That's where the gas tanks are sitting and staying, is just like that. So I really appreciate you guys watching. And this will probably be the first time, and I don't know if the last time, but it's definitely the first time you guys are going to see me in a minivan in the Demolition Derby ring. So thanks for watching. Make sure you guys watch some of the upcoming videos. And you'll see me smash this. I don't know where it's going to go yet, but a bone stock minivan, there's got to be somewhere to run it here in Ontario, even with Coronas going the way it is. So thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you back here tomorrow on Zach's Workshop.